हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन द न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स मैटलैब प्रोग्रामिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी हाउ यू कैन फाइंड राइट द मैटलैब कोड ऑफ द मेथड ऑफ लीस्ट स्क्वेयर फॉर कर्व फिटिंग। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर घर, वर्किंग इन द स्कूल ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स थापर इंस्टीट्यूट इंडिया। यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी, ईदर ऑफ माई ईमेल आई डीज आर देयर, एल्स यू कैन सिंपली फॉलो दिस लिंक फॉर फाइंडिंग द वेरियस वीडियोज ऑन द मैटलैब प्रोग्रामिंग। So in this lecture, we will see how you can find, how you can draw the MATLAB code for this curve fitting, which is the part of this previous one, that is a numerical analysis and its MATLAB code. So where you can, in this lecture, we will also see how you can utilize this Gauss elimination and the Gauss-Jordan methods are there. So the objective is to write an efficient MATLAB code for the problems like this way. If you have some series X and Y, then how you can write this how you can fit the curve like straight line, parabolic or the second degree, cubic, and many more are there. So our task is to write the generalized code for such problems. So how we can write that? So I can divide this lecture into the five phases. The phase one is how you can input the valid x and y, like here. This is the valid x and y. How you can choose the required degree of the polynomial, like if n is 1, then it is my linear. If n is 2, then it's a quadratic, and so on. So that's a generalization. After that, we write the normal equations, and then we will write use any one of them. So we will discuss all these three methods in this video. Finally, we can print the solution. So first of all, what is the curve fittings are there? So what is that? If you want to put as a linear equation, then the linear equation is a plus bx. If you put them as a quadratic equation or the second order, the equation will be like here, or you can write this quadratic equation also as of here, ax square plus bx plus c. That's all depending upon you. So similarly for here, you can write like this way. So that's all depending upon you. Then you have to write this normal equation like this way. So I think all of you know that how you can write the normal equation from here. Similarly for the quadratic equation, there are the three unknown variables. There are the three equations out there. You can easily write this equation in terms of ax is equal to b, where x is nothing but my here, this is my a, this is my x, and so on, and similarly. So our target is to write the MATLAB code of such equations into the MATLAB. But if you closely look about that, the size of this is my 2 cross 2. The size of this is 3 cross 3. But if you think about that, if you substitute the cubic equation, the size will be 4 cross 4. So how you can write the generalized code? In this video, we will see how we can write a single code which is working even for this as well as for this. So what you can do is you have to think about how we can write the generalized code. So in order to think about this, you have to express, you can see this part like here. This is the terms of the x and y. While on this side, these are the totally terms which are dependent only on the x. So we can express each term with respect to x, like here. Can I write this part as x raised to power 0 into y? That is a term of the x and y. This is also in terms of the x and y. I can write these terms in terms of the x. So I can write here as x raised to power 0, like here. You can see x raised to power 0 in terms of the x. So this is the value completely dependent on the x, while this is the value which are dependent on the x and y. Similarly, for this side, you can change this value. I can change this value in terms of the x. You can write like here, x raised to power 0, this is x raised to power 1, and so on. After that, what you can think in your MATLAB programming. So whenever we are thinking on the MATLAB programming, this is my first row. This is my second row. So you can write this one, you can utilize this one, how you can write this 0 in terms of the 1. Can I write this as a 1 minus 1? Can I write this as a 1 minus 1? Similarly, this is my second row. You have to think about this, how you can correlate with the second row. So this is 2 minus 1. Again, I can write here as 2 minus 1. Similarly for here, this part I can written like this way. You can see 1 minus 1, this is the first row. This is the second row. Similarly for here, you can write here as 1 minus, this is the first row, this is the second row, this is the third row, and so on. And you can see that I can generalize them to the n variable, 1 minus 1, 2 minus, and so on. Similarly, you can think about this for the first row. I can write this as 1 minus 1. Similarly, I can write this as my 2 minus 1. Similarly, I can write this as 1 minus 1 and so on. Since this is my second row, so I can express all terms as 2 minus 1, 3 minus 1 and so on. Similarly, you can express these three rows accordingly. Like this is the first row, so 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3 minus 1 and so on. So if you generalize them, you can see this is a 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3 minus 1, next one is a 4 minus 1. 2 minus 1, 3 minus 1 and so on. So your target is to express this into the MATLAB programming. So how you can express that? If you think about this is the, if you think about the ith row, what is the ith row? If you start with the I, the next value will be my I plus 1. Next value is I plus 2. So I can write here as I plus 1, I plus 2, and the last one is I plus n. And if you write on the right hand side, this is nothing but my I minus 1 of y is there. So what is the meaning of that? This I is my number of the rows. And what is my j? J is my column. So this is my first column. You can see this is my first column. This is my second column. This is my third column and so on. So j start from here. So what is the meaning of that? It means I can write this individual element of here like of this. That is a summation of x j minus 1. If you consider this as a j. So what is that? Each element is considered as my j minus 1. So what is the conclusion behind that? It means we need the two loops while writing this equation into the MATLAB. So let's see how we can write this into the MATLAB programming. So we can start with this one. Say our target is to find this, whether you want to use the square line, linear, quadratic or whatever is there. So you can start with this one, format short, clear all and the CLC. So what you can do is, I can summarize all these MATLAB code into the five phases. You have to start with the format short, clear all, CLC. Whatever I will discuss in this phase one, you just copy that text and write here. After that, you can write the phase two, after that phase three, phase four, and then phase five, that's the end of the code. So I can discuss the first value as the input, the value of the X and Y. So you can ask the users, you can use them, input the X from the user, enter the value of X in this form. Similarly, you can ask the value of the inputs, the value of y from the user. So once they will input the value of the x and y and make sure that the length of the x and the length of the y is must be the same. Otherwise, you are unable to create the curve fitting tracing. So what you can do, you have to put the condition, if length of the x is not equal to the length of y, then it means there is an error. So you can put as the error dialog box, length of the x and y are not same. If you run this file, you will get something like there. So this is the error dialog box, length of the x and y are not same. This is the same line whatever I have written here. So when once the length of the same is not, then you can display the message to the user. Instruction for the user is check your inputs and re-enter it. Once you will ask them re-enter, how they can re-enter is, you can say press any key from the keyboard to continue. Once they will ask them, you can re-enter the value of the x, re-enter the value of y. So if they they input the value of the x, check again whether the length of x and length of y are same. If not, again they will display the error and so on until the length of x is same as length of y. So this is my phase one. This is the way you can input the value of x and y from the user. Now phase two is how you can choose that. So this is the n. So if you choose n is 1, it means this is the linear. It means you have to curve fit the value of the x and y as a linear curve. If you choose n as my 2, then it's a quadratic curve, or you can say the second degree or the parabolic. If you choose n is 3rd, then it's a cubic and so on. N is 4 and so on. So what you can do is you can again ask the users, n is a minu, choose the polynomial. Like a linear, quadratic, cubic and so on. So you can try to write this on your MATLAB window and press the enter. You will see this window will appear. What is the meaning of that? Now if I see is a linear. So if somebody wants to click on this, it means the value of the n will be, now this is a first option. So n is my 1. If somebody clicks on the quadratic, then n is my 2. If somebody clicks on the cubic, then n is my 3. If somebody click on the higher degree, that's more than 3. So n is my 4. So based on the user input, the person can decide for the curve fitting. So what will happen if they choose first three options? So n is well defined. But if somebody choose as here, it means higher degree if n is a greater than 3. If you choose n as here, like this, this value is 4, so 4 is greater than of this 3. Then you can ask the users enter the polynomial degree for the curve fitting, whether they want to write as n4, whether they want as a 5, and so on. So that is my choosing the polynomial degree n. So that's my phase 2. Now the major phase is you have to write the normal equation, that is this. Ax is b. So where a is written like this way. So there are the two loops. One start from the I, from 1 to the number of the rows, and j is my one I to this. So firstly, I can define this initialization of the a. So why it's n plus 1 is there? Because if you put as a linear equations, then the size of them will be the 2 cross 2. If you put as a quadratic equation, then there are the 3 unknown variables, then the size will be 3 cross 3. This is for my n is 1. If you choose n is 2, then it's a 3 cross 3, so that's why n plus 1 here. Now we need the two loops are there, I and j. We can start for the first loop, I from 1 to number of the rows are there. Similarly for the j, you can see from the j start from the I to n plus I is there. Now I can write this expression, that is aij is sum, this value is my sum, x raised to power j minus 1. So if you run this file, you will see for this, if you enter the value of x, enter the value of y here, you will get this output. But clearly see that this is not the correct answer. Why? Because if you put as a quadratic equation, then your answer will be like here. This is a normal equation. The size of this will be 3 cross 3. And you can see the size of this is my 3 cross 5, which is not true. So why? Also, you know that this is a square matrix. It is not a square matrix. Why it happens? Actually, this value should be here. This value should be start from here, but it is not be there. Why? Because whenever you are taking the row as a 2, so the j value start from the 2, 3, and so on. That's why this start from the second column. If you take in as a I as a 3, so what is the meaning of that? That is the third row. So the j start from the 3, 4, and so on. So that is not the correct answer. So what you can do is your target is to start the value of the j itself from the 1. How you can put them j start from the 1? So initial value is my here. So what you can do is this is I plus n. So that's very simple. How you can put them as a 1? So if I subtract my I from each them, it will be my 0. It is 1, it is 2, and this is my n. But we need here as a 1. So how you can start them? Simply you can add 1 on each side. Now you can see it start from the 1, 2, and up to the n plus 1. This n plus 1 is represent my size of this. So it means I can replace this column value to be j minus I plus 1. How? See, I can replace the value of j minus I plus 1. Nothing is to be changed here. That is I of j minus 1 is there. Once you will write this instead of this aij, instead of this, you can write here, and then if you run this file again, you can see your output will be like here. Now, also, this is the value of the a. You can write the value of the b on the right hand side like this way. So again, that's a very simple how you can add this is the sum. This is the summation part. You can write as a sum x raised to power I minus 1 of y. So that is my b of this. So once you will run this file, you will get the required output of this as a and b. Now once you will get the system here, then you can start the phase 4. You can solve this with the help of the Gauss elimination. You can solve this Gauss Jordan or the a inverse b. So I can discuss one by one. So let's discuss firstly this. So by a inverse, that is you can write as a inverse of a multiplied by b, you can find the x optimal value. This is the x optimal value. Similarly, and once you will get the optimal value, you can print the solution. Solution of the given system is display x optimal. This is the simple method out there. But if you want to solve this with the help of the Gauss elimination or the Gauss Jordan, what is that? In order to write the Gauss elimination or the Gauss Jordan, you have to firstly write this matrix as a argumentative matrix. This value I have stored in the matrix A. This value I have stored in the form of the capital B. So my argumentative matrix is written like say A, B. And once you are writing here, then what is the purpose of the Gauss elimination is, you have to transform this matrix into the lower triangular matrix, while on this Gauss Jordan, what is the meaning of that? You have to convert into this identity matrix. So that's a very simple, let me explain the firstly one by one. So the Gauss elimination method, as we already discussed the previous video on the Gauss elimination, you can see here. So what is that? We can firstly define this argumentative matrix AB, and then whatever the I have explained this code, that is a Gauss elimination video, I can put each of the lines as here. That is I to J, I can define the key elements and then use the elementary row operations. The detailed explanation of this you can see in this video. Similarly, if you want to see on the Gauss Jordan, again you can use any one of them. So now if you want to use this solution with the help of Gauss Jordan, you can see I can define the firstly argumentative matrix, and you can watch this Gauss Jordan MATLAB code video for the explanation of this part. So make the diagonal entries as a one, because the Gauss Jordan means you have to put all the diagonals as a one, and then on the right hand side is my values are there. So make all the diagonals one, and then you can proceed the elementary row operations. Now, so you can use any one of them. So either you can use the Gauss simulation, you can use this code. If you want to Gauss Jordan, you can use this. If you want to use the A inverse B, you can use them. So that's depending upon your choice, whichever you want to use. Now that's the end of the phase four. Now finally you can print the solution. So in the Gauss Jordan, you can see this is the diagonal entries. So this is my optimal solution. So what is that? This is the end column of my solution. So this value is stored in the form of the AG. So I can write here as AG of the end column. So this end is represent for my here. This is my optimal. Once you will get the optimal, you can print the solution. Solution of the given solution is here. If you want to see the Gauss simulation, you can see this is the matrix you have computed. Then you have to use this as a back substitution. Again, it is described in this Gauss elimination R there. So back substitution, you can use them like here. You can use x3, x2, x1 are there. So you can write as a sum. You can write this expression, sum of this and so on. Finally, you can write this expression divided by the diagonal entries A11, A12, An. So the final optimal solution is here. Again, you can put as a display of the optimal, that will be the right answer of this MATLAB code. So this is the way you can print the solutions as of this curve fitting are there. So that's a summary of this course are there. Whatever I have explained, the phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, you can simply learn from these phases, write the code one by one into here. That will be the end of this MATLAB code. So make sure this code will help you. If you want to put n as a 1, it will fit the straight line for the given data. If you substitute n is 2, then it will curve it as a quadratic equation. If you put n is 3, n is 4, that's depending upon your choice, they will fit accordingly. And finally, you can find the optimal solution by either of their methods. If you want to find some another videos related to MATLAB programming, you can simply follow this link by section 2nd, regular false. You can see that this is the MATLAB code of the Gauss Seidel, and this is the Gauss Jordan R there. Also, you can see the Simpson 1/3, this Newton forward Euler methods, modified Euler methods, and many more are there. So if you need any other help, you can simply ask me through my email IDs are there, or else simply follow this link for finding the updated videos. Till then, best of luck students, happy learning.